One of the limitations of AI tools is inability to do math. So Julius AI has solved that problem. With Julius AI, you can just upload your qualitative or a mixed method data, and then just with a test, providing a clear prompt, the system can analyze your qualitative data or mixed method data or quantitative data for you. And it's so amazing how it performs so well. So I'm going to share with you this powerful tool and trying to make sure that you understand the process of how the system make sense of your data and provide you the needed information, or that will help you to write your report. So the good thing is that this system can conduct statistical analysis. You just tell the system, can you determine the relationship, or can you run the relationship between these two variables? And the system can run it for you and provide you the results, and then even share with you the best way of presenting the findings in APA format or in other formats that you want. This software solves the problem of math in terms of AI to giving you correct answers in terms of math. And it's also very good for people who have limited knowledge about statistics, but want to analyze their data themselves, right? And this is going to be helpful for you. It can develop graph, as you can see here. It can create chart and graph for you. It can also give you some insights depending on the kind of prompt that you provide. It can do advanced analysis, providing predictions and forecasting. And it can also problem solve. It's so interesting and so powerful too. You go to Julius, check my video description, and you can see the link there so that you can click on it. But when you go to Julius AI, what you have to do to start is to click on start a chat. So as you can see here, default, in terms of the model that the system uses, it uses both GPT-4 and Cloud AI. That makes the system so powerful. And then when you put it in default, the system will decide the kind of model it has to use based on the task that you want the system to complete for you, right? So I always put it in default as for the system to decide which model it should use to analyze my data for me. Advanced reasoning. Let's say you want a system to take some time to predict, to forecast, to do complex tasks, you can click on this one to help the system to engage in advanced reasoning. And as you can see here, there are two programming software that are available here. You have two options. You can let a system use Python or use R programming. That helps the system to run statistical analysis. As you can see here, this platform is so good because it uses two of the most powerful AI tools and also use Python and R to help you to, you know, run the statistical analysis, right? So let's try something and then you see how powerful this software is. You can click on chat to start, and you can also go to chat to see any kind of conversation you have had with the system. You can click on previous chat and then continue having conversation, or you can also delete if you want to delete. You can even rename. Files are the place where you can upload all the files that you want the system to analyze for you. You don't have to do it here. You can do it directly when you start the chat. You can upload files and ask the system the questions that you want. You can also review information about privacy issues. So let's go back to chat. Let me show you the document first. It's an SPSS document. So as you can see here, it's about age and memory. Imagine you want to find out whether there's a relationship between age and memory, right? So you can see that it's an SPSS data, and you can see age and memory here. And when you scroll down, you see that we have 40 participants, right? So let's see what we're going to get. We're going to ask the system to run correlation or determine the relationship between these two variables. So first, you can drag and drop or attach your documents. So it can be in Excel spreadsheet, it can be in Word document, it can be in SPSS format, right? So now I have attached my document. So what I will do is that I will say, can you determine whether there is a statistically significant relationship between age and memory? Then I click on enter and let's see what we're going to get. It tells you what it is doing. It provides you the step by step. It's showing it work, how it's reasoning, how it's doing the job. And that's what I like about this software. It doesn't just give you the answer. It tells you what it's doing, right? So that you understand the process. It's showing it work. This is amazing. So this means that when you have your answer, you can explain to people what exactly you did or what the system did for you. So I think it's finished doing it. So we can go back here and look at the results. Here it's telling you what it was doing. The first step is to load the data from the age versus memory file. It loads the data and then it checks the structure and the quality of the data. So it checks and makes sure that everything is right, giving you information, a little preview, right? And also giving a summary, telling that there are 40 observations. Yes, there are 40 participants and their ages range from 18 to 48. And the memory is 48 to 75. And it's also telling that there's no missing data. Wow, it tells you everything before it starts running the analysis. It's giving you all the background information. Now it's visualizing, giving you the scatter plot, right? And you can download it, you can adjust it, change the name. So it's giving you the scatter plot, and then it's telling you that the Pearson correlation between the age and memory is 0.33, indicating a moderate positive relationship, suggesting that as age increases, memory score tend to increase as well. But the relationship is not very strong. So you see how the system has provided you the answer to your question, and it's giving you other information about regression equation and also the R squared and the p-value. And you see here the p-value is less than 0.05. So this means that there's significant relationship between the two variables. So it explains everything to you. So if you have little background with statistics, you can use this one and even help you to better understand the findings. And it's as if like you have given your data to an expert to run the analysis and explain it to you what they got. So it's tend to, it also suggests what you can ask the system, right? Explore the impact of gender on memory scores. I think we don't have a data for gender, so we don't have to click on this one. It will tell you that, you know, there's no data for gender. But as you can see here, it can suggest some questions for you that you can ask the system to be able to get information if it's in the questions are relevant. Now, let's say you want the system to write the results in APA format. Yes, you can also ask the system and the system will be able to do it for you. Can you write the results in APA format? Perfect. So you can easily get this information and use it to help you with the results, right? See how that provided you the best format, giving you the p-value and also the r-value and the degrees of freedom and all the information that you need to write the result. It's amazing. This is the regression that I have provided to you. So you see how easy to understand the steps and also the results. And you can also ask further questions. You can ask the system and to explain it to the numbers that you have here. So that in case you want to present this finding and people ask you the numbers, you'll be able to explain. And as you always see, it also suggests some things for you. And if it's relevant, you can click on it and the system can run, or you can get access if you click on these questions. So now let's move to another data. Imagine that you have done a survey, right? You have surveyed a mental health providers, and he wanted to find out from them their perception about mental health stigma and what we can do to prevent that, right, or to reduce the stigma. And then, as you can see here, there are 100 participants. These are their demographics, their age, gender, education, experience, and also we have the potential patient types that they see as they provide service to people with mental health issues. And also thought about stigma and discrimination, the causes of stigma, stigma factors, and other questions. And you see that they provided open-ended responses. So, and lastly, you also measured their cultural intelligence, and then this is the score for their cultural intelligence, right? So you see how we have mixed data. We have the qualitative and quantitative data, the open-ended responses and also the closed-ended responses, including their demographics, right? So now let's try and see whether we can ask the system some questions. I have some few questions. So let's start a new chat. And then we're going to bring the new data that we have here. So I drag and drop that. And then I have some few questions to ask the system. You see how it has given you a preview. So whenever you upload Excel spreadsheet, this is what you're going to get. It will show you the data that you have attached. This one is so helpful. You can look at it and ask the system some questions. Let's start with maybe demographics. You can say that, can you create bar charts and bar charts and pie charts reflecting participants' gender and education? And let's see what we're going to get. So here is showing that you're using Python to do that. Great. This one is for the gender. You can download it. As you can see here, 50% females and 50% were males. You can see educational level two here. And you can easily download. Let's see the download one and see whether it's clear. So it normally put them together. You can easily access the system to separate these two diagrams. So you see how it can just create a wonderful diagram for you, right? Based on the demographic information that you want. Another thing that we may be interested is, the question that I want is, what are the perceived causes and contributing factors to mental health stigma according to mental health providers? So what you can say that, can you review the open-ended responses and address the following questions? So you see how the system has provided us some answers based on the question that we have. Sometimes these AI tools may give you wrong information, right? So another way to really check is that you can tell the system to extract relevant information based on the output that it has provided to you. So you can say, can you extract relevant excerpts from the data supporting the 10 factors you have just provided? So this means we want a system to go through the data and extract evidence or quotes from participants in support of these factors. So you see that it has gone through the data and extracted information. You can also tell the system to indicate who made those statements. Is it participant 1, 2, or 3, right? That is another way of checking. You can also copy and then search for some of the information from the data to make sure that these are truly from the data, but not something they made up, right? So that's another way of checking. It's always good to check. You don't want to over depend on the results without making some kind of checking and auditing to make sure that the information is correct. Let me ask the last question, qualitative question, and see what we're going to get. So I wanted to, so I said, what additional measures do mental health providers suggest could be taken to address mental health stigma? As you can see here, it has provided all the themes that are addressing the question that I asked. And you can also ask further questions about specific evidence from the data in supporting of the themes. You can do that. So as you can see here, it can analyze both qualitative and quantitative data. What I always advise is that have your data in Excel spreadsheet or CSV so that system can easily analyze your information. I hope this one was helpful. If you have any questions, please let me know. I'll be happy to address your questions for you. If you want to try out this AI tool, you can look at my description. I provided a link there for you to use. Thank you for your time.